Welcome,
no!
Everyone. I see
just
you've
when I started,
met some of the many
freaking
we
choppy
in this class.
All this stuff. Though I don't know what's going on, man. Come
none
on.
None of these creatures should be taken lightly. They are all in their own way dangerous, especially if one does not know how to handle them properly. Now, it seems many of you are out of practice. Let's take some time to review the basics of how to care for a beast, shall we? Miss Sweeting, would you please assist our new student with the lesson today?
Yes, Professor Howen. Hello, I'm Poppy, Poppy Sweeting. Don't worry about Professor Howen's speech. She over-exaggerates sometimes. All the beasts in class are perfectly safe.
Oh! Miss Sweeting, pay attention, please. The tongue of a puffskin can be a slippery devil.
Yes, Professor. Here, you can practice on Gerald.
My baby.
Just keep an eye out for his tongue.
Who this?
You can use my brush.
Gerald.
Just be gentle. Oh, and think pleasant thoughts. I like to think it enriches his experience.
Okay, but why is it still choppy, man? Come on, bro. See, look, this looks smooth right here. Smooth. I don't know what's going on, bro. Oh, you gotta do that? That's weird. Bruh.
That's lovely. I'm sure he feels much better. I think he might be hungry. Would you mind giving him some beast feed?
Beast feed.
What do you suppose the pellets taste like to Gerald? Pudding, I like to think. I think we can safely say that Gerald likes you.
That's good news. He seems very nice.
He is. Kindness is one of his best qualities, right after ambition. And cleanliness.
Good work, everyone. Now, let's make our way to the pens and select another beast. And please, do be careful as you feed and groom them. Miss Sweeting, why don't you show our new student to the Neasels in the farthest pen?
This way. The Neasels are over here.
Oh, man. Beast class.
Oh,
okay, now I'm looking smooth.
A couple of Neasel whiskers ought to get me a few canuts at least. Enough to buy something from Honeydukes. Stupid thing.
Oh?
What in Merlin's name are you doing?
Tuss, peculiar Poppy. Worried about a worthless little rodent.
Her name is Persephone!
Her name is Persephone!
What you doing in the background?
That's really not funny.
Let's go.
Trying to mess with the gang.
Those two don't belong anywhere near this class. Poachers in training. Persephone was onto them instantly. Thank you for your help. Let's carry on. Feed and brush the Neasels just as you did with Gerald. The Neasels really took to you. They know a...
It appears our time has come to an end. Please close the pens and see yourselves out. Now, where is our new student? Ah!
Literally in front of you,
bro. There you are. I would like a moment, please.
Hello, Professor. You wanted to speak with me?
I did. How did you find your first beast's lesson?
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class.
Good. You seem to understand that when beasts are properly controlled, they can play a vital role in our lives. Some provide us with magically imbued materials, if cared for correctly, which does not include torturing them for whiskers. Well done, by the way. Probably best to let me handle it next time.
Yes, Professor.
They're nearly as bad as the savagers in Rookwood's poacher pack. Sadly, we're the ones who suffer, stumbling over dead beasts. Terrible waste of resources.
Surely the poachers can be brought to justice by someone. The Ministry, perhaps?
An optimistic idea. Now, why don't we focus on more immediate matters that we can control? Professor Weasley has asked that I prepare some assignments designed to help you catch up to the other 5th years. Be on the lookout for my owl. Meanwhile, I also encourage you to study as many beasts as you can on your own time.
Psst, psst, over here.
Do you need something, Poppy?
Thank you again for saying something to those brutes so that I didn't have to. You were an augury at noon in the desert.
I certainly hope that's a good thing.
It's something my gran and I say. It means that something sure, you know, or someone good, is a you know welcome surprise. At least, that's what we decided it meant.
I couldn't stand there and watch them harm the poor thing.
We're of a similar mind. Actually, in light of that, there's someone I'd like you to meet in the forest.
Can't forget to let you down.
You've intrigued me.
Intrigued?
Very well. Lead the way.
I'd hoped I would. I wouldn't take just anyone there. In fact, you're the first.
Appreciate it.
Really? Well, thank
got
you.
Got a new fit on.
I think.
Got this red mask.
I was trying
to make him look like Red Hood.
Pleasant surprise.
But nothing close to Red Hood, so I just give him a red mask and like this little fit right here. All right, you Red Hood. I'm the Harry Potter universe of Red
Quite
Hood.
Quite the weather we're having, don't you think?
Poppy, where are you taking me?
It really is much better if I just show you.
All right. Doing some weird
Don't
thing,
worry.
Poppy.
We're nearly there. It's just ahead. Stand back.
I think that is all. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Ooh. Look at this beautiful creature.
Please meet Highwing.
Highwing?
Isn't she just magnificent?
I know a Nightwing. Because I'm Red Hood.
Go on, introduce yourself to her. But be careful. You must always show hippogriffs the proper courtesy before you approach them.
Bow before me. Another bowie. Like respect.
I knew it. I don't think I've ever seen a hippogriff take to someone this quickly. You can feed and brush her if you'd like.
I'll feed her.
I come and check on her every once in a while. Bring her pasties, tell her what's Eat going on in the castle.
Yeah.
You wouldn't know from looking at her.
I know
her,
you love it. I see them hearts. I see them hearts, girl.
Busybody.
Let me brush you up, girl. Yeah, looking feathers. I really love that. I see them hearts. Push you up, girl. Whoa. Peace.
So, what did you think of Highwing?
Nightwing? Yeah, you know what I'm saying.
I thought she was brilliant. Can't believe you introduced me to her.
I suspected you two might get along.
Are you the reason students have been seeing hippogriffs flying above the Forbidden Forest?
Perhaps. Did you know that once you earn a hippogriff's trust, they'll always be there for you? I've seen it firsthand with her.
How exactly did you and Highwing cross paths?
It's a longer story, but I rescued her from poachers a few years back. Got her to safety and, well, she was fine until recently. You may have noticed that poachers are something of a problem in the area, so I worry they could get her again. And I might not be there next time.
Yeah. Professor Howen mentioned the poachers as well. She seemed to imply that we couldn't rely on the Ministry to help.
I don't often agree with Professor Howen, but on that, I fear she's right. The poachers' influence is growing. I see them every day in the village, lingering, talking to people. They're up to something. I'm just not sure what.
That does seem strange. Sounds as if they're planning something.
Exactly. I think I'm going to look into it. Find out what's going on. What they're doing.
I think that's a fine idea. Oh. Information is power.
And the more I know, the better I can keep Highwing safe.
You seem undeterred. Will you let me know what you find out?
Oh, very well. I will. I should be going, but we'll speak again soon, I hope.
Oh, okay. She's going by herself. I thought it was like quest together type beat.
Hello again, Mr. Moon.
Mr.
Moon. Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young
friend. What's good, my dude?
Gladwin Moon, Hogwarts caretaker, at your service. First, please allow me to apologize if I seemed a bit unsteady when we last met. I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not! From what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there? Watch what happens when that light changes from day to night.
Day and night. Playing.
What?
Now, if you wouldn't mind humoring me for a moment, see if you can remove the moon from the statue. Ooh, the odd moon. Little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed. Which, incidentally, can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk.
Alright.
Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle.
For
a fair
real?
Number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart. Or shapeshifter, if you will.
Oh, okay.
Which takes the form of whatever scares you most.
Revelio
took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes. Terrifying creature that can see the future. Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises. The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play on my name. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Oh. Why me?
A couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go near them.
Okay.
In fact, I know of two statues right here in the faculty tower. Perhaps you could start simply by removing them so I can go about my evening duties.
All right. What's in it for me?
Why would I do this? Seems all risk and no reward.
Oh, rest assured, there's very little risk, and there is, in fact, a reward.
Nice, dude.
I will teach you a particularly useful spell.
Right.
First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
Curfew? Oh, tosh. I sense you're a bit like me when I was your age. Oh, the school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it. Oh, everyone loved me for it. Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital wing. Good luck. Oh, and thank you.
Okay. Oh, we got a new spell. Bet. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Unlocking doors. That's what we needed.
Alohomora.
Oh, what in the world? Oh, heck no. What is this now? Okay, something like that. Oh yeah, this feels like a lot like Bully,
well,
alright?
You're in.
Got classes,
remember,
got
stuff to unlock. Remember, use a disillusionment charm so no one claps eyes on you. This is a restricted area of the castle after all.
Oh.
Alohomora.
Let's go, baby.
How are your students getting along this year?
Rather poorly, I'd say.
Is that so?
We're raising a generation of...
Gotta be really, really quiet. Gotta make sure we... Oh. Oh. Hold up.
This must be the prefect's bathroom.
Bro. Let's go. Let's go. Oh.
Loyalists are preparing for a rebellion. Rouge, he's always mucking about, stirring up trouble. Perhaps Ranrock and his lot wouldn't be so complicated if the ministry would allow them to have one.
Alohomora.
Okay.
Nice. Ooh, that was scary. Okay, let's go.
Not at the moment, no. Plenty of other perils and pitfalls. Well, I suppose I should begin my rounds now.
Oh, God.
Students are terribly disappointed about Quidditch being cancelled. Ravenclaw?
I know when I see a winning bet. And Ravenclaw would not have been that. Not this year, anyway.
I'm partial to Hufflepuff myself. What was that?
What was what?
I was finally going to learn the Quidditch rules.
It's a majestic sport. Encompasses the whole of the human condition.
Oh. How's that?
Well, all of the teamwork and flying about and the golden snitch. Rather a lot like life, isn't it?
Oh, I suppose I should...
Ooh, gotta get up out of here.
I suppose you should.
My boy.
Hello, Mr. Moon. I have the moons you asked me to collect.
Oh, goodness! You're as fearless as I'd hoped. An excellent start. If we can collect more, it may shed some light on who's behind all this. Of course, I first suspected Peeves. He drove the previous caretaker, Rancorous Carp, to an early retirement with his intolerable buffoonery. Peeves. But that does not explain the boggart in Hogsmeade, does it? No. I am determined, with your help, to discover the identity of my tormentor.
It's definitely intriguing.
Intriguing.
I'd like to help you solve this mystery.
You, my friend, are a gentle person and a scholar. And I have something to offer in exchange for your assistance. Now, remember, the moons are only retrievable at night. Thus, I encourage you to use a disillusionment when necessary.
How many statues are there to find?
I don't know precisely, but I've spotted dozens. Seems they're everywhere I look. You have your work cut out for you, if you were to ever unravel their meaning.
All right.
You mentioned offering something in exchange for my assistance.
I did. Once you've brought me enough moons, I'll show you even more powerful forms of Alohomora. Not every lock is as easy to pick as the faculty towers.
All right, keep looking.
Understood. I shall keep an eye out.
I appreciate that. Oh, and I knew you were the one to ask for help. Keep at it so we can solve this mystery.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Ooh. Hello, Miss Ryan.
I wanted to thank you again for your help with Rookwood and Harlow the day of the troll attack.
Serona, please. And I was happy to help.
Serona?
Oh, those two are nothing but trouble. Glad you and your friend were here when they found you.
I am too. Yeah, you were speaking to a goblin here that day.
Yes, Lodgok. He's a friend.
It seems as though you were on good terms with him.
I've known him for years. We met when I was waiting tables here as a student, well before I bought the place. He was cordial enough, but we weren't friends then. His mistrust of wizard kind ran deep.
But you're friends now?
We are. I hadn't seen him in years when he came in a few months ago. But he recognized me instantly, which is more than I can say for some of my own classmates. Took them a second to realize I was actually a witch, not a wizard. Not all goblins are like Ranrok and his loyalists. Lodgok is as worried as the rest of us about what's been going on.
In that case, I'd like to talk with him, about Ranrok in particular. Where might I find him?
I assume your interest is to do with the rumors I've heard about Ranrok working with our friend Rookwood.
It is.
If he's not here, you might find him doing business at the Hog's Head. He's a trusted metal trader. You should mention that we spoke. He can, understandably, be wary of witches and wizards, even ones as young as you.
Okay.
That said, if you're looking for information on Ranrok to help rein him in, you'll find an ally in Lodgok.
You seemed unfazed by Rookwood and Harlow the other day. They don't scare you.
They're bullies. Plain and simple. Never tolerated them in my own
bullies.
Life, and certainly
we're
won't tolerate
bully,
them going after my friends.
Edition.
Don't misunderstand me. They're dangerous wizards and shouldn't be trifled with. They should, however, be confronted and reminded, whenever possible, that the rest of us have each other's backs.
Have you heard what Ranrok and Rookwood are working on together?
Not much more than the fact that they seem to have some sort of uneasy alliance. Friendship between wizards and goblins is rare enough, but between those two, they each want something the other has. I can guarantee it. That said, I fear they're like a two-headed serpent. Both will need to be taken down to stop whatever scheme they've been plotting.
Thank you, Serona.
If you find Lodgok, please give him my best.
Okay.
I don't know what you've done to make such powerful enemies, but please, watch your back.
Because I am the Chosen. Chosen.
Hello, Lodgok. Serona said I might find you here.
She did she? Did she send you with news?
No, actually, I wanted to speak with you. It's about Ranrok.
Now I remember. The Three Broomsticks. Day of the troll attack. You're the student he's after.
I am. And I need to know what he and his loyalists are up to, so I can stay a step ahead.
Let's say I did know. Why should I trust you?
Serona said our interests may be aligned. Perhaps she was wrong.
Well, if Serona believes we have common goals, then it is possible that we can trust each other. Very well. I may know of something that could help us both. A way to get Ranrok to confide his plans to me.
I'm listening.
Years ago, a heinous witch stole a sacred goblin relic. Rumor has it that it now rests in her sarcophagus. In a tomb accessible only by wizard kind. Ranrok and I had a falling out a while back. The relic could well repair the chasm between us.
Oh, okay. Sounds like a trap, but I'll retrieve it.
Very well. I'll retrieve the relic if you promise to share Ranrok's plans with me.
We will have to trust each other. I, that you will not abscond with the relic, and you, that I'll share what I learn. Gather whatever supplies you may need, and meet me near the witch's tomb. There's no time to lose.
All right, let's go.
What precisely is the relic I'm to retrieve?
A valuable heirloom known as the Helmet of Urtgot. The witch considered herself a collector, and purchased the helmet as a trinket. She cared not what pain she caused the goblins. Goblins believe that the rightful owner of any object is its maker, not its purchaser.
Wizard kind see things differently. It's a wonder goblins and wizards have ever been able to work together.
The differences between our kinds are myriad.
They seem to be.
It may surprise you to know that I do not believe those differences always to be insurmountable. It is the reason I find myself traveling with you to this tomb today.
Oh. Well, long as you don't backstab us, you know what I'm saying? We all good. We need that information. For real, Zol. Just collecting these just cuz. Man, I need to do a lot of side quests, bro. I'm just focusing on the main mission. Okay. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this. Equip gear that you have found, purchased, or upgraded. Oh, okay, never mind. I can't read that. Wait, what? Y'all better back up.
Ah, and there it is. The witch's tomb.
Dreadful looking place, isn't it?
This is the tomb. I've been here before, I think.
I wish you luck retrieving the helmet. As a wand carrier, you should have
advantage. I haven't, but I've been on the waypoint.
Now, before you set off, do you have any questions?
The fast travel thing, that's it.
What about this helmet makes it so special?
The helmet of Urtgot is an ancient and storied relic, forged during a time of unity among the goblin clans. It inspired greatness, that is, until it was no longer ours. Then it became something else. A symbol of what has been lost, of all that wizardkind has taken from us. Reclaiming it would mean a great deal to goblinkind and to Ranrok. He would be grateful to me should I return it.
It seems Ranrok and Rookwood are conspiring. Why would that be?
I had heard this. When the dark-hearted conspire, they seldom make their full intentions clear to one another. I can only speculate, but I imagine their alliance is uneasy and quite fragile. Let us hope that ours is less so.
Okay,
don't
one more
suppose
question.
You have any idea what could be waiting for me inside the tomb?
Considering a dark witch was involved, I suppose there's a chance
dark
you may
wizards.
Encounter the dark protectors, known as Inferi. The foul creatures thrive on darkness and the cold. Vanquish them with light, force, and most effectively, fire.
Okay.
It all seems clear to me now that we're here.
I do hope our alliance proves fruitful. Again, I wish you luck. I will remain here, eagerly awaiting your return.
Lumos. Where do you go, huh? This place is big. Let's go.
Merlin's beard.
Merlin's beard. Not my character saying it. Merlin's beard. What is going on? Ooh, I got a scarf. They're looking really scary out here.
This can't be the witch's tomb. Likely I need to go further.
Hey. Perfect timing. Oh, there's
Lumos.
Three.
Accio. Lumos.
Gotta collect everything. Alright. Got one right here. Need one more. Oh, wow. It just came out of nowhere. Oh, wow. Alright, let's go. Wait, what? You telling me that's the same Lumos. One?
Lumos.
Ah, oh, there you are, you little sneaky sneak. Got one of them just come out of nowhere.
I have a feeling I'm not alone here.
Uh-oh. It's the undead nightmare!
Confringo!
Stay back! Confringo! Back up, bro. Okay, we got more B-fly. We got one right here.
Lumos.
Wait, can I get both of them? That'd be dope. Nice. Wait.
If I could power it somehow, it looks like it could be rotated.
Oh, wait, let me get one of these dudes.
Accio.
There we go.
Revelio. Lumos.
All right. Lumos.
What's that hanging there? Precarious. It's sealed shut from the other side.
Go.
Down I go. No other way.
Oh yeah, it's down.
Oh.
Oh. Oh god. Whoa, we swimming around now?
Fringo!
Back up, bro, back up. Oh, whoa, 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 what is wrong with you, man?
Lumos.
Go.
Lumos. Lumos.
Let's go. Show me the witch.
The witch's final resting place. Lodgok said the helmet was in her sarcophagus.
Confringo!
Dead Ashwinder. Your compatriots must have made off with the helmet. Lodgok won't like this. Better show this to Lodgok.
Damn.
I know there's a mechanism to open this door.
Alright, let's go, let's go. Got some bad news.
The sarcophagus had been raided. I found no helmet, only a dead Ashwinder.
Damn! They got here first! We need to get it before Rookwood uses it to further ingratiate himself to Ranrok. I saw one of their campsites not far from here, but I fear you must go in alone. My fighting days are behind me.
I'll head there now.
Good. There's no time to lose. Get to that helmet before Rookwood does, or we will lose our chance at any leverage, no matter how small, with Ranrok. To think those wretched thieves have their hands on...
Yeah, I know. We're gonna pull up on him. Yeah, we're gonna pull up on him. Yeah, boy, he's flying. Oh, they don't see me.
Expulso! Potato!
Confringo!
You've made a grave. Knew you were still Confringo.
Hold on, bro.
Back for more.
Hold on, bro.
You're the one who uses the dark arts. I'd recognize. You let Nora Treadwell go, didn't you? You had a target. Arrest the momentum.
Oh, he got hit. He got hit. I got hit. Jesus.
Vulture.
Vulture.
Confringo!
He's still alive, bro!
Expulso!
Glacius!
Expulso!
Confringo!
Expulso! Expulso!
Glacius!
Arrest
him a minute! Confringo!
Bro, he's done for. He's done for.
Expulso!
Confringo!
Nobody will believe I defeated an Ashwinder by myself.
That's it.
Uh-oh.
This is for Rookwood!
Try not to make this too easy for me.
Get out of here, bro. Who are you, bro?
Confringo!
Had enough? You're going to regret that.
Confringo! Defender! Glacis!
Let's go, boy.
Shame nobody saw that. Leave the helmet from the Ashwinders.
Well done. This is sure to impress Ranrok. The helmet shines even more brightly than I imagined. The etchings, the contour of the profile, remarkable.
Oh, damn.
It looks stunning, Lodgok. I see why you wanted it back.
You did the thieves a service by recovering it. I know many a goblin who would have killed for it.
Ah, then I am glad to be rid of it myself.
Thank you. This should earn Ranrok's trust. I will take it to him immediately. It may distract him from his search.
His search?
It is merely an inkling. You have impressed me greatly, friend. I'm glad I trusted you.
Appreciate it.
We shall speak soon. Best to keep our arrangement quiet for now. Many will not believe that our aims might possibly be aligned.
All right, for sure. All right, I gotta go back to the city because I need something so I can learn a new spell.
Ah, Deke is so happy to see you. Deke noticed this bag in the room the other day. You must need it to help with your schoolwork. Deke has seen one of these before. Deke calls it a knapsack.
Oh, appreciate it, man.
Perfect for gathering and transporting beasts.
Nice.
Pleasant little breeze.
I have been thinking about something Professor Howen said in Beasts class, that I should study as many beasts as I can on my own time. She also mentioned that poachers have been active in the area. So, perhaps the beasts will be safer with us than out on their own.
Precisely what Deke was thinking.
Deke.
You see, the room knew exactly what you needed. And luckily, Deke can show you how to best use the knapsack and where.
Oh, shit.
Come along, then. Our first stop will be beyond the castle grounds. We can leave now, or you can come and find Deke when you're ready to go.
I'd like to ask you about changing the room's ambience.
Of course.
Light the room.
Oh, son.
How to do that
I'm
real
ready
quick?
To learn how to use the knapsack.
Perfect. Deke loves an outing.
Now I just gotta wait and check up on all that stuff. We're going knapsack. Yeah, I had to do that real quick, and next thing you know, I had to do this with the knapsack. But then from there, I'm going to go back to the town and talk to
a nasty poacher. Deke hated working for him. He did horrible things to beautiful beasts.
Whatever.
It was during those days that Deke first saw a knapsack. It'll be nice to see one used for good.
Okay.
We have arrived. Deke enjoys coming here to watch the beasts, especially the Puffle of Puffskeins nearby.
Puffskeins.
It will be nice to keep them safe. All you will need to do is get close, direct the open knapsack toward the Puffskein, and in it'll go.
Nice.
All right.
Let's do it. Yes, sir. Oh, nice.
You got one.
I accidentally shoot it at it.
Rescue Puffskeen.
You can rescue as many as the knapsack will hold. Poachers capture Puffskeens and, well, Deke isn't sure what they do with them. Deke is certain they will be safer with you.
I'm gonna sell them, bro. I saw a video there.
Simple to rescue
as a
Puffskeen.
Kind of quick money.
Deke suggests you next find a beast that can fly. A job and all, perhaps.
All right. Where would I find one?
So I'm playing this on the PC, but I heard on the PlayStation 5 version of Hogwarts, you get to have your own store.
Must be careful.
I'm like, what? Deke has seen why only PlayStation 5 exclusive, man? Why not PC?
Deke will meet you there
or Xbox?
Whenever you're ready.
Apparently, they said that they're going to put it like in a year later for us to get our own store. I want to get my own store already, man. Come on, bro.
Hello, Deke. Shall we continue?
Oh, good. Deke was worried about you, what with all the poachers in the area. Perhaps we should work quickly. The Jobberknolls are just here in this large tree. If it's helpful, Deke has seen Levioso used to slow-flying beasts. Easier to get in close and use the knapsack.
Levioso, okay.
What if I can't find any beasts in their usual habitat?
Beasts won't stray too far from their homes. Look nearby or simply wait a moment and they should return.
Do you have any advice on how I can rescue more elusive beasts?
Levioso is not only helpful when rescuing flying beasts, it can also help rescue beasts that are generally hard to catch. Try using that spell the next time you encounter a small or otherwise elusive beast.
Would you mind talking a bit more about what it was like working for your former master?
Deke's master was not kind to beasts, or to Deke. He saw beasts only as a source of income, to be used for potion ingredients and labor, and Deke will not say more. But Deke is grateful to be at Hogwarts, where he can help care for beasts and make amends for the things his master made him do.
I shall go and rescue a Jobberknoll.
Good luck. Deke will be waiting.
Let's go. Let's go. Oh, there's two of them.
There. I'm not going to hurt you.
One, two. Dude, this is amazing, dude.
Everything's all right now.
Ah, man, I needed one more. I guess that's it. Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's good. It's good.
I rescued a Jobberknoll.
Deke hopes your Jobberknoll finds the knapsack nice and cozy. Poachers want them for their feathers and are not kind when they gather them.
Are there any other beasts nearby?
Just one that Deke knows of. A herd of moon calves. They live in a clearing of trees up this footpath. Deke will see you there.
All right, more. Peace out.
Indeed, your field guide. Hello, Deke. Is this the clearing you mentioned?
It is. Moon calves gather near the large tree with the spiral pattern in front, but only under the light of the moon. So, unfortunately, unless you have a way to hasten time, you might sometimes have to wait until nightfall to see them.
How did you end up at Hogwarts after working for your former master?
Deke's prior master had no family, so when he died, all of his house-elves were relocated by the Ministry. Deke was the most fortunate one, as Deke was sent to Hogwarts. Deke's friends were not as fortunate.
I shall go and find a mooncalf, then.
Deke will be waiting for your return.
All right, so he said nighttime, huh? So, do this, go to the map. R3. Yes.
We gotta wait day and night. Wait, wait.
No need to be difficult. I mean you no harm.
Let's go! One, two, three.
Professor Howard will never believe this.
10 out of 10.
Arrest the momentum.
Let's go. Let's go.
Settle yourself. I mean you no harm. It was a bit trickier than the others, but I have a mooncalf now.
Another beast, safe and sound. Shame we didn't see the moon calves dancing. It's a marvelous sight. Deke supposes you're finished here. He'll be able to rescue many more beasts, but for now, let's bring the ones you've gathered back to the room.
All right.
Deke will meet you back in the room whenever you're ready.
For sure, Deke. Deke!
There you are. Now, where's we need to stuff? Show the beast you rescued, then you home. But, not enough room to let them out here. Imagine all those beasts running amok. That wouldn't do at all. Perhaps if you focus on what your beasts need, the room will provide.
Oh, they need some things? Oh, well, damn.
What exactly did you think of?
Damn.
Heavens! You've done it!
Mm-hmm. I hear you.
Deke isn't sure. Only one way to find
out.
To
go inside.
Meet you inside
when
you're ready. Oh, that
is so dope. I just made a freaking backyard, bro. Yo, what? Amazing!
Look at this! It's amazing!
Where are we, Deke?
It seems to be a place for your beasts to live, a vivarium of some sort. Oh, your beasts will be quite comfortable here. They'll live healthy, safe lives.
Perhaps you want to release them. Let them see their new home.
Alright. How do I... Okay, I guess, will I go over here? Oh, wait, no, what the heck? What is that showing? Purple. Alright, press R1. One. One. And one. I'm gonna, you know, one each, you know?
Oh!
This is cool.
Deke thinks the vivarium will be a fitting new home for your beasts.
Indeed. I only hope we'll have enough space for all of them.
Deke hopes so too. But if you do run out of room, Madam Peck at Brood and Peck in Hogsmeade will help to find safe homes for them.
Any beasts that the room can't hold?
Yes, she's well known for helping to care for beasts in need, and she'll give you a fair price for them. Speaking of care, beasts that are well-fed and groomed will provide you with valuable magical materials, such as puffskein hair, for example. Okay. If you gather some magical materials from your beasts, Deke can show you how to use them.
Very well. I shall let you know when I have some.
Dude, that's dope. Jesus, a lot of stuff to do, man.
Deke's no herbology professor, but some plants here seem to be ready to harvest.
Give us food. Where's the other ones? Give you some food. Come back. Groom you up. Nice, dude. Oh, I gotta wait. Ah, that's some crazy stuff. All right, cool. Okay, 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 nice. Deke!
I've collected some magical materials, Deke.
Now Deke can show you how to use them. First, you'll need to use this spellcraft to conjure an enchanted loom.
An enchanted loom?
Exactly. It will allow you to use your magical materials to weave magic into the very threads of your clothing, making your clothing more useful in a variety of ways.
Oh, hell yeah.
Why don't you try it?
Hell
yeah. Deke thinks you'll be impressed with what the loom can do.
I'll go and experiment with the loom now.
Oh, hell yeah. I'll just let him stay there. Saloon. Oh, my clothing. Nice, dude. Oh, okay, okay.
That came out nicely. I should show Deke.
Deeky Deke.
I used the enchanted loom, Deke.
Wonderful.
Will I be able to weave even more powerful magic into my clothing with the loom?
You will, by rescuing even more powerful beasts.
Oh, that is insane.
For now, however, Deke suggests you explore the vivarium and get to know the beast you've already rescued.
Nice.
Can I use the loom to enhance any item of clothing?
The loom will only enhance clothing of a certain quality. Deke suspects you'll find more valuable clothing as you explore. Deke also knows that some of the shops in Hogsmeade can provide you with a variety of clothing you to enhance.
Thank you for your help, Deke.
Deke is the man. Dockweed and depth. What is that? Nice. Alright, let me talk to this professor real quick so I can learn this new spell, and then I'm going to end the video here.
I've finished the activities you assigned me, Professor Garlic.
Wonderful. I hope you gained.
Took me a while because I needed money, but I did it.
In our lives.
I did it, Professor.
I am forever enraptured by it. Just yesterday, I spent hours pruning my self-fertilizing shrubs and flutterby bushes. Didn't realize how long I'd been at it until the sun began to set. Well, if there's one thing I love to see more than my plants thriving, it's one of my students doing the same. Now, ready to learn Flipendo?
Yes.
Chin up,
Flipendo.
Keep a light grip, and it's all in the wrist.
Flipendo.
Let's see you give it a go. Whoa, whoa, whoa,
whoa. Which is flipping over things, bruh.
You will want to focus with this spell. Nothing is mortifying as knocking back a colleague when all
you almost missed that. I almost missed that, bruh.
Wonderfully done. If you'd like to practice a bit more, you're welcome. Here in the green.
Confringo. Places. Confringo.
That is so dope. Hey, and we level 20, bruh.
Verna, I received your owl. How are you?
I wonder if it's like
Hello,
a side
friend.
Mission, probably.
Did you ever find Lord Gog?
I did, thank you. In fact, we're working together to try and rein in Ramrock.
Are you? I suspected you and he would get along. Perhaps best I don't know details of your plans. Then I shall refrain from telling you to be careful yet again. But I hope you will be.
I will. You know
of course.
Saying.
Your owl mentioned you're needing my help with something?
I do. I thought you might be just the person to do a favor for my friend Dorothy Sprottle in Upper Hogsfield.
I don't believe I've met Mrs. Sprottle.
She's lovely. Her late husband, Aidan, was a friend of my father's. In fact, I'd stay with Dot and Aidan the summers I waited tables here as a student. I've seen her a few times since Aidan passed, but the pub's been so busy lately, I've not been as attentive as I'd have liked. I wonder if you might pop in and see her. She may need some help collecting ingredients for her supply of Wiganweld potion. And you could retrieve something of mine in the process. A box, full of old letters and such.
Why is she like,
Why does Mrs. Sprottle keep a supply of Wiganweld potion on hand?
Dot's a skilled potioner. She's been supplying travelling vendors with Wiganweld potion. An ordinary precaution that has, unfortunately, become a necessity, what with Ranrock's loyalists disrupting the trade routes.
Why did Mr. and Mrs. Sprottle have your box of letters after all this time?
It's one of a few that I had when I was young. Dot found it when she was clearing out a closet. Can't imagine what's in there. Probably terribly theatrical. The ramblings of a teenage witch and her friends. You're welcome to take a peek inside, if you do find it. To be honest, I'd imagine it contains some lovely memories.
I'll try to go and see her when I can.
It would mean the world to me, and to Dorothy. Aiden was bringing the box of letters to me when he was taken ill. Doc can tell you where he might have dropped it.
Alright guys, I'm going to end the video here. Leave a like, subscribe for more Hogwarts Legacy. Stay posted, your boy's out. This is it, you know what I'm saying? To the next video, we will continue this little side quest and try to, you know, get whatever we need out the way and then focus on the main mission. But yeah, man, this game is so goated, bro. It's so goated. Goated! Leave a like, subscribe. Hogwarts is goated. Peace.